Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. This is a YouTube channel for people that love dogs. If you guys haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. Just recently, I decided to create a new show. It's called The List, and this list is basically community-generated top master breeds. So I have 10 breeds here that you guys yourselves voted on. All right, guys, so let's get into this list. Coming in at number 10, and this list, like I said, was voted by the Dogumentary TV community. This is your list, it's not my list. I like this list. Number 10, the Tibetan Mastiff. The Tibetan Mastiff is a flock guardian dog, obviously originating in Tibet. As with all livestock guardian breeds, this dog does bark a lot. It also patrols perimeters. It's a good property and home guardian. But I do feel like if you're going to get one of these dogs, you really should be using it with livestock. It's just natural for the breed. In terms of health, this is a very healthy master breed with a lot of Tibetan Mastiffs living between 10 and 16 years. And they're a big breed. Now, typically, when they're working, they're not as big as the dogs that you will see in Western countries or in China, where they've actually supersized the breed for show purposes or for money purposes. Working Tibetan Mastiffs typically weigh between 121 and 198 pounds. And 198 pounds is a big dog, but just think about the logic of it. If you are a nomad and you're working, you don't want a 250 pound Tibetan Mastiff that you're gonna have to feed. Probably move a lot slower than a smaller Tibetan Mastiff and probably do half the work in a day. So I know a lot of folks like the bigger, better thing, but I do believe that working dogs are smaller for a reason. And that reason is that they're probably more efficient at doing the job. Coming in at number 9, the Neapolitan Mastiff. The Neapolitan Mastiff originates in Italy. This is a master breed that was developed to guard and defend family and property. They definitely have protective instincts, and their appearance pretty much a deterrent in itself. Not only does the Neapolitan Mastiff have a fearsome look, it is also fearless. This breed was used back when it was legal to bait bear, bulls, and jaguar. The breed typically lives about 8 to 10 years. That's, I think, being generous. That's based on my research, and I think that's being generous. Probably 6 to 8 years if you're doing with the show line. Maybe the 8 to 10 years if you were doing with working Neapolitans. I would say that's very much likely. Males of the breed weigh between 130 and 150 pounds, and females are between 110 and 130 pounds. Coming in at number 8, Dog de Bordeaux. The Dog de Bordeaux originated in France, specifically in southern France in a region called Bordeaux. That's how the dog got its name. Like many master breeds, the Dog de Bordeaux is a family protector and home guardian. It is often said that the Dog de Bordeaux is more bark than bite, meaning that it uses its loud voice and intimidating looks as opposed to actually engaging in any kind of fight. The Bordeaux's head is said to be the largest in the canine world relative to the size of its body. Male Bordeaux's come in at about 150 pounds max, females 125 pounds max. The breed has a life expectancy of about 5 to 8 years, which is not great. All right, guys, your number 7 dog, the English Mastiff. Now, the English Mastiff is the basic ingredient for all Mastiff breeds that were developed in Europe. This is a very huge dog that today has been kind of bred away from its working abilities. I would love to see if anyone out there has working English Mastiffs right now. That would be a great video that I hope to make someday. But this breed is extremely huge, and it has been bred for its size and for being huge. It is without a doubt, according to the record books, the largest dog ever. Typical size for a male is between 150 and 250 pounds. Females are between 120 and 180 pounds. Males are about 30 inches tall. Females are about 27 and a half inches tall. The life expectancy of the English Mastiff is about 8 to 10 years. I would suggest that those are 8 to 10 years are for dogs on the smaller size in regards to the English Mastiff. The number 6 breed, the Rottweiler. Now, you know this is my favorite breed. It's number 6 for you. The Rottweiler is one of the oldest herding breeds. It was developed from the old Roman war dog, which basically was a cattle drover. When the Roman armies moved through Europe, they brought these dogs along to push cattle. The cattle they ate. So you obviously back then they didn't have refrigeration or the means to preserve food. So these dogs were a necessity, and they would basically, like I said, move the cattle and protect the cattle. Today, the dog is less of a herder and more of a home protector, guardian dog. In terms of size, Rottweilers are between 110 and 132 pounds for males, 77 and 106 pounds for females. Males are about 27 inches tall at the max height, and females are 25 inches tall at the max height. Get you a good Rottweiler, you could expect 8 to 10 years in terms of life. I believe if you work real hard, you could probably get 12 to 14 years out of a Rottweiler. All right, guys, we're getting into the top five. Your number five dog is the Presa Canario. This dog comes from Spain. This breed was originally bred to work livestock on farms. You would use these dogs to basically catch and hold your large farm animals. Whether you were moving them, whether you were taking them to slaughter, that's what these dogs were used for. In addition, these dogs were used to protect the farm from wild dogs or other predators. And it does have a little seedier history as well. Before 1950, these dogs were often used in dogfighting competitions in the Canary Islands. But obviously that's long ago, so different times. The lifespan of the Presa is gonna be about 8 to 10 years. I feel like, again, if you treat the dog right, you can get more than 10 years out of a Presa. The number four dog, the Bull Mastiff. The Bull Mastiff developed in England during the 19th century. It was developed by gamekeepers to guard estates. These breeds were basically a mix of the English Mastiff and the Old English Bulldog. They were bred primarily for size, strength, and speed. And this meant that anytime a poacher encroached upon somebody's land, it was this dog's responsibility to apprehend and hold that poacher till the gamekeeper came. Today, this breed is more of a family companion. Like I said in the last video I did, I am looking for working bull masters. So I'd love to see what they do. In terms of size, males are about 110 to 130 pounds. Females are about 99 to or about 120 pounds. Males can be as much as 27 inches tall, and females are like 24 to 26 inches tall. And your number three Mastiff dog is Dogo Argentino. The Dogo Argentino is an intelligent and courageous dog. It has a strong and natural instinct to protect. Therefore, it probably is not necessarily great for inexperienced dog owners. But if you are very committed to the dog, you can learn your Dogo and you can have a healthy relationship with your Dogo, but you want to get your Dogo socialized. The breed was developed in Argentina by Dr. Antonio Norris Martinez. In terms of my online research, they have the breed coming in between 88 and 99 pounds for males. I've seen much larger Dogos that were healthy and working. And then they have, for females, they have between 88 and 95 pounds. Again, I've seen 110 pound female Dogos that worked. And in terms of life expectancy, the breed should live between 10 and 12 years. All right, guys, we're all the way up to number two, and that is the South African Mastiff, the Borbul, which obviously originated in South Africa. These dogs were bred to work farms. They are basic farm dogs, but farm dogs that work in farms that were surrounded by an insane predator load. And not only is the predator load large, but the predator load is efficient. You have lions, you have hyenas, you have wild dogs, you have leopards. So Borbuls are incredible dogs, and like I said in my other video, they have the utmost of respect for me for the fact that they were able to sustain and thrive in such a what I would consider to be a harsh environment in Africa. In terms of size, the breed is a very large Mastiff. Males can be anywhere between 143 to 176 pounds. Females are anywhere between 110 and 143 pounds. And the life expectancy for a Borbul is about 10 to 12 years. All right, guys, we're up to number one. The number one Mastiff breed, according to the number one dog community in the world, that's you guys, is the Cane Corso. The Cane Corso originates in Italy. It is a large guard dog that is an amazing companion. The breed was used to guard property, livestock, and families. Today, the breed is more of a companion, but still there's a lot of working Cane Corso blood out there. These dogs make excellent family protectors, excellent home protectors. These dogs are incredibly smart. They're easily trainable. A lot of these dogs actually do protection sports now. So if you're looking for a home protector as well as a personal protector, you cannot go wrong with the Cane Corso. In terms of size, males are between 99 and 110 pounds. That's based on online research. My practical experience with the breed is you can get them to Cane Corso can get well up to 120, 130 pounds and still be healthy and in working condition. Females are about 99 to 110 pounds. In terms of life expectancy, the breed lives about 10 to 12 years. You know, so that's a good amount of time to have a dog in your life. All right, guys, that's it. That's your list. I appreciate all of those of you who commented. If you guys haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. All right, peace.